Welcome to chapter 5 of thermodynamics, which is mass and energy analysis of controlled volumes. There will be two videos in this chapter 5. The first video will be from chapter 5.1 and 5.2. Now, the objective of this chapter is listed here. You can just read up on it. Chapter 5.1. Talking about discussing about conservation of mass. So conservation of mass, like energy, mass is also a conserved property. It cannot be created and destroyed during a process. So we have closed system which where mass is actually remain constant during the process. Remember what I told you about closed system, the earlier one? Okay. Now in controlled volume, mass and energy can cross the boundary. So we must keep track of the amount of mass entering and leaving the controlled volume. Okay, since that you have mass conservation, so what we have here is like example like this. 2 plus 16 means 2, let's say 2 enters a tank which is 16. So at the end of the day, the mass is actually 18. Yeah. So mass and energy can be converted to each other, which is from the formula of E equals to mc square, where C is actually the speed of light. Yeah. So this is the mass and volume flow rate. So mass flow rate will be the m with the dot up there. It is kilogram per second, or it can be gram per second depending on the question, where rho is the density, v is the velocity average, and the a would be the cross section area of the pipe or of the place that we are calculating. Okay, so it's given by m dot. Or m dot is also rho v with a dot. When you have the dot up there, it is actually rate. Yeah, it's divided by time. Yeah, divided by time. Yeah. So what we have here is that volume flow rate is given by meter cube per second, where we have velocity multiplied by acceleration. The area cross section. So if let's say you have a pipe, so the area cross section will be pi r square of this pipe here, and then we have the velocity. Let's say the velocity is whatever the value, 8 meter per second, okay, multiply with let's say 8 meter square area. So we have meter multiplied with meter, we have cube, meter per cube second, okay. So that is about it. Next, we're going to move on to conservation of mass principle. Okay, like example, mass entering plus mass leaving. If you minus that, will be the net change. If you take this water tub example, 50 is coming in, 20 is retained in the tank. So how much will go out? Yeah, 30 will go out. So this is how you do a mass balance. Yeah, it's very important when you calculate. When you do mass balance for like a system or a process, yeah? Okay, so these are the formulas for just mass balance. So the most important at the end of the day is actually this. Mass in minus mass out. Mass in equals to mass out, okay? Where if you have mass in minus mass out, it means there is something that is retained at the back. Okay, otherwise, mass in equals to mass out. Yeah, this is for steady flow process. So what is a steady flow process? I have explained this before, but I'm going to redo it here. Steady flow process: the total mass contained within a controlled volume does not change with time. Yeah, it will not change with time. The rate of the mass that's going in is the a steady flow means the mass that's going in will be the same at all time. Okay, like example here, you have 2 kilogram per second. 2 kilogram per second is 2 kilogram per second at whatever time. It is not fluctuating, it is just a constant. So that is steady flow. Okay, like example this one, 3 means is 3 throughout. There's no fluctuation. So you have 2 kilogram per second plus with 3 kilogram per second. So how much will come out? 5 kilogram per second. So in this syllabus, we only study on steady flow. We do not study on any object which is non-steady flow. Yeah, so when you do a steady flow, you will see that mass in equals to mass out, rho, the density, yeah, velocity, multiply with area. Yeah, so this is the formula for it, for the single stream. Okay, so we'll be looking at many devices such as nozzles, diffusers, turbines, compressors, and pumps, which I will go into the next class. Yeah, now we do not study on incompressible, we study on incompressible flows. Yeah, we don't study on compressible flows. Yeah, we only study on incompressible flows. So what is like incompressible, like liquid, fluid, yeah, all these are actually incompressible. We don't study much on gas. We don't look at compressible flow in this syllabus. Yeah, okay, so conservation of mass is a relation can be simplified even further with fluid that's incompressible. So usually you have in equals to out. Yeah, so what is this V is meter cube per second. Steady, it's a steady flow. Okay, so this is an example of a compressor. So you can also there's only conservation of mass. Yeah, there is no conservation of volume. Yeah, there's no such thing of conservation volume. You only have two conservation. What is one is your mass and your energy. You do not have a volume conservation. No, it doesn't work that way. It means like volume can be 1.4 and coming out is also like whatever value. Yeah, because it all depends on the area, cross-section area as well. Yeah, for steady flow of liquid, the volume flow rate as well as the mass flow remains constant. Liquid are essentially incompressible substance. That's for incompressible substances. Okay, now we're going to go into 5.2 where flow of a fluid, yeah, has got work. Yeah, there's a flow work or flow energy. The work required to push the mass into and out of a controlled volume. Yeah, so the work is necessary to maintain the continuous flow of the controlled volume. So what is the formula like? Work flow is force times the length. Okay, force times length. If I open up, what is force? Force is pressure area. Okay, so area length is actually volume. So that's why you finally get workflow is PV, pressure times volume. Okay, pressure times volume. So if pressure times volume, you get kilojoule per kilogram. So this is the workflow's formula. Okay, so when you combine them, so what's going to happen is that you remember the previous formula we had, U, KE and PE. So you have an additional one, which is now the workflow. Can you see that? Yeah. So for questions which doesn't have non-flowing fluid, you don't talk about the PV. But for flowing fluid, you need to look at flow energy as well. So the formula becomes with additional another component inside. Yeah. So the energy that's transported by mass. Yeah, we're going to look at that. So this one. This one, you remember, you have PV plus U plus KE. Yeah, that's the formula, right? Okay, and you still remember, right, from the previous chapter, you have H equals to U plus PV, isn't it? Correct, right? So can I substitute? Yeah, look at this area here. Can I substitute? So when I substitute, what happens? It becomes H plus V square over 2 plus GZ. This is kinetic, this is potential. So it becomes H, enthalpy. From internal energy, it becomes enthalpy. So the energy that's transported by mass will be given by the formula of M, mass, multiply with enthalpy. Where do you get this enthalpy value? From the back of the textbook, or sometimes given in the question. Most time you find it from the back of the textbook. V square over 2 plus GZ. Okay. If you talk about rate means divided by time. Just take whatever value that you have calculated, you divide by time. The unit will be kilowatt. Okay? So when kinetic and potential energies of the fluids are negligible, yeah? So what happens? If let's say there is no movement of fluid no movement of the whole object. The object is not having velocity or the object is not being elevated. So the component of KE and PE becomes zero, leaving you with mass equals to mh. Yeah, once again, h is enthalpy. So with that, before I go in into the next chapter, I will just solve a question. Yeah, so that you would understand this better. Okay, so steam, this is a question, question 5.3 from the textbook. I'm just looking from a question from the textbook. So let's calculate. So they are actually asking you to calculate a few things here based on this chapter that you have studied. Energy transport by mass. Steam leaving a pressure cooker, 4-liter pressure cooker. Yeah, the volume is 4-liter. Okay, who's operating at pressure 150 kilopascal, decreased by 0.6. So the volume actually decreased by 0.6 liters, volume decrease in 40 minutes. The time would be 40 minutes, volume decrease. Okay, cross-sectional area of the opening. Cross-sectional area of the opening, the area, the cross-sectional area is 8 millimeter square. Watch out, this unit is actually in millimeter square. Okay, so determine the mass flow rate of the stream of the exit velocity. So A is to determine the mass flow rate. B is to determine the total and flow energies of the steam per unit mass. So this is a steam. Okay, we need to know, yeah, whether it's water, refrigerant or whatever. Okay, so the steam leaves the pressure cooker at a specified pressure. Okay, and then you read up. Yeah, okay. The assumptions. What are the assumptions that you need to make? You of course need to make some assumptions. The KEPE is zero. It's a steady flow. Yeah. And then your saturation condition exists within the cooker at all times. So that the steam leaves the cooker at saturated vapor at cooker pressure. So, okay. Now you have to find the, once again, you have to find the mass flow rate. So what is the mass flow rate? Your kilogram per second, right? That is your mass flow rate. And exit velocity. Look at that. They want the mass flow rate and exit velocity. They want mass flow rate and exit velocity. So how do you do that? Okay. Let's look at it. Yeah, the volume is okay. So it is saturated vapor. So the properties of saturated liquid water vapor at 150 kilopascal. Why 150? Because the pressure is 150. Pressure in the question is given 150. Okay, go to the back of the textbook. Remember the table? Yeah, from there you can get your VF. Why are we looking at VF? Because we write down all the values actually. We write down VF, we write down VG, we write down UG and the HG. So YG, G is the vapor, F will be the saturated liquid. Okay, so these are the values. So once written, keep that aside. Okay, okay, analysis. We need to find the saturation condition exists in the pressure cooker at all times. Okay, that's done. Okay, the mass. What is the mass? So it will be, you see, from the back of the textbook, you have meter cube per kilogram, correct? You need to find the mass. So what do you do? Liter divided by mass cube per kilogram. So what is liter? 1 meter cube is 1000 liters. So you, from there you convert, you get your mass. So this is the amount of mass that is actually involved in this process. So what is the mass flow rate? You take the mass, you divide by time, you get the mass flow rate. You have answered the first question. Now what about the volume? How do you find the volume? The volumetric flow rate. Volumetric flow rate, you take the mass that you have calculated just now. Okay. You divide by the rho g multiplied by AC, area. Yeah. Okay. So let me just check the unit. Yeah. We just want to check the unit. Kilogram per second. Multiply meter cube per kilogram. So you get this cancel, you get meter cube per second. You need to cancel to get the velocity, you need to get area. So this formula will be m, a mass times volume divided by area. Mass times volume divided by area. Area given in the question, which is was just now 8 millimeter square. Millimeter square, yeah. 1 meter is power of negative 3 meter, right? Millimeter. Correct. No? 1 meter is 1000 millimeter. Okay, so cube means, square means you double up. So that's why it's power of negative 6. Okay, so VG will be from the steam table itself, because it's steam, right? Okay, the volume will be from the steam table itself, volume specific. So you, when you plug in, you can get the meter per second, the velocity. Yeah, okay, so this part, the first part is done. Once the first part is done, we will move on to the second part. So what is the question for the second part? Let's look at the question. And before that, I'll just erase all this. Okay, the question for the second part. The question for the second part is the total flow energy per unit mass. So we have all this value, just keep it aside. Okay, next we are going to find the total energy flow. Okay, so E flow will be PV. We just saw previously, right? Just the formula. So what is PV? PV is H minus U. Very simple. You just have to take the HG and the UG. What's the HG value from the steam table? HG, UG. Minus that, you get your workflow. Okay? Now the total will be, you take this value of H, KE, PE. So in this case, KE and PE is almost nothing, right? So it means the total energy will be the H value. So we are answering both the question. The total and the flow energy of the steam. Total will be the total, the big total, this one. The flow energy will be PV. Okay, so with that, we have done this part. And the last part of the question would be the rate at which the energy leaves the cooker. So the rate at which the energy leaves the cooker, rate. Rate means whatever value that you have calculated, you divided by time. Yeah. So in this case, did they give you the time? The rate. Okay. Is the time given? The time. 40 minutes is for what? Has decreased by 0.6 in 40 minutes. Okay, the M will be, I'm just looking for the values, right? This is the M which we have used, the 40 minutes, 2.37. okay, kilogram per second. If you see me, you see sometimes you want to develop the formula, you can also, one thing, memorize the formula itself. Another one is to play along with the units. Okay, you know, at the end of the day, you want kilojoule per second. You understand? So I want per second. So mass flow rate multiply with the energy. Settle. Yeah, so we have kilogram per second multiply kilojoule per kilogram. Kilogram and kilogram cancel. So you have kilojoule per second, which is 0.638. So in this case, your M rate will be the one that you have just calculated. And the theta will be the value that you have just found also, because your KE and PE is zero. So you just solve the question. So with that, if you have any question, do let me know. Yeah, we can just discuss it together during the consultation hours. Thank you.